Business has a big impact on children's lives. Since 2012, business, NGOs, and governments have backed a global standard, the Children's Rights in Business Principles. These principles define how business should respect and support children's rights. This goes beyond just avoiding child labor. Growing up, children need special protections and guidance, caregivers who are there to look after them, products they can use safely, healthy environments to grow and play, and the right kind of work when they reach working age. In a global, interlinked, and interdependent world, how should you as a company navigate your direct and indirect impacts on children and decide where to focus? You need to prioritize. The Children's Rights and Business Atlas helps you do that. The Atlas was developed by the Global Child Forum and UNICEF to help business understand and mitigate its impacts around the world. We know the rights children have, and there's real-world data to back it up. Thanks to UNICEF, the ILO, the World Bank, and many other organizations, the Atlas has statistics that measure all the critical outcomes. Data like wages and working hours in the workplace, children's injuries from products in the marketplace, and child malnutrition in communities. Putting these data together gives us a children's rights map of the whole world. And you can drill down to examine detailed ratings for every single aspect. So how does it work? In any industry, you start by understanding your industry's known risks, which are also outlined in the Atlas. Then, check how vulnerable children are to those risks in a given country. Take the technology industry, for example. Say you're with an ICT company that sources its products in another country. You decide to examine your children's rights issues in the workplace. In the industries section, you see that decent working conditions are high risk in the ICT industry. The Atlas outlines how low wages and excessive working hours for working parents in ICT factories directly impact their children. Unregulated overtime and long periods of work without rest days leave parents with less time to spend with their children. Young children may even be left at home alone for long periods. Then, map the workplace risks in the country. In the Atlas, you see that decent working conditions make up the highest risk for children in the country, both from the weak legal framework and the high number of reported violations. This means you'll want to prioritize decent work in this region. Now you can bring focus to your due diligence. By conducting a children's rights impact assessment and stakeholder consultation, you explore opportunities for positive impacts on the lives of factory workers' children. Working with your supplier factories, you enforce a code of conduct and build your supplier's capacity to enforce the same requirements on its suppliers. And you partner with a local children's organization to fund childcare facilities. In doing so, your company ensures that working parents have more time at home with their children, and their children can receive proper care while they're away. To protect children's rights, companies need to assess and act on children's risks in the workplace, the marketplace, and the community and environment. The Children's Rights in Business Atlas can help you identify and prioritize children's rights risks. It's a free, easy-to-use data platform to find opportunities to use your company's influence to benefit children's lives. As your company takes responsibility for its impacts on children, you can not only manage risk, but gain recognition for lasting contributions to the future generation.